Dominic Reyes and Jon Jones fights coming up in your division. So you, I know you got, like, you say you're not worried about it, but like, what do you?
Oh, I'm definitely keeping an eye.
That's what I'm saying. You got to keep an eye. How do you see that fight cracking off?
Man, Jon Jones is easily the best. He's the best.
Isn't like every time I ask somebody that, it's like, yeah, it's Jon Jones. I'm like, yeah, that's Jon Jones.
He's the best.
How he's managed to stay, like, because in the
he's gone through like three or four generations. Like,
yeah, and the other thing is, in the light heavyweight division, where you're only one punch away from getting slept. All the time, like
yeah,
it's not like it's not like doing it in the bantamweight right. or featherweight division where
it's if I touch you or you touch me or Jimmy touches you, we're going night-night.
Yeah, but to be able to keep that record, it's
and against the cats he's fought, bro. Like let's like if you really look at his body of work, he won that belt against Shogun, who is still in the goddamn top 15 yeah. 10 years later. Like yeah. that's outstanding.
Still putting. Guys asleep too.
Still catching bodies.
And it just because he probably just doesn't get the credit he deserves because of the.
Because he's a dickhead.
The only person.
Hey man, let's not judge a guy for snorting lines. Shit. Happens,
yeah,
he got to get loose somehow.
Yeah. Yeah. Fuck, that just makes him more impressive, doesn't it?
Yeah, that just makes him
more impressive. Imagine if you actually trained for him.
Oh like, my God.
And think about the fact that he came back on that DC fight. He popped hot for blow fight week.
A lot of it, not just a little bit.
Not a picogram. That motherfucker was running 4 grams. Like, the idea that like you're banging lines the week before a UFC title fight. Like, I don't know whether to look at it like this dude is a reincarnation of Mike Tyson and they just don't give a flying fuck, or is it a mental break in him, or is he just not focused? I really don't know.
Fuck, it's gotta work for him.
Yeah, it's clearly working, right? And he fucked him up in that fight.
He did fuck him up.
He did, yeah.
Bro, I can't say anyone's gonna beat Jones.
I don't see it coming, man.
But
All right. I'm gonna put you on the spot. Let's say we're 3 years down the line. Jimmy gets his fight back. Go beat the shit out of Misha. I want you to fight Shogun just because I think it'd be fun to watch. Get a big fight ahead of that. We're 2 years away now, right? We're gonna do UFC Melbourne. Jimmy Crute, the big hotness out of Australia, out here. He's 26 years old now, ready to fucking scrap. Jon Jones, still getting around. His picograms is hot, you know? But it's all right, because they got rid of USADA because they realize it's fucking shit up in the UFC, right? So Jones is a little bit beefier, but he's moving slower. How does Jimmy Crute come out to fight Jon Jones?
You know,
we've all thought about it, bro. We've all sat around and thought about it.
I've sat down with Sam, and I go, how the fuck do you beat Jon Jones? And he's susceptible to leg kicks.
Very susceptible with those little.
But the problem is, people go, "Oh, the chicken legs work for him because it's bony.
It's bony. Yeah. So
you're kicking a bone,
and if you're not placing your kicks perfectly, and yeah. cutting an angle and cutting, you're getting shin every yep. time.
And that works for him. Like on the commentary when he was getting calf kicked, they were saying how the small legs would be. Bad for calf kicks. And it's actually better for him to be kicked in the calf.
Like you got a thick ass leg. I kick that. That's going to hurt you.
Yeah.
If you're just kicking fucking leg, like bone that has been fucking fighting at the highest level for a long time.
Yeah.
That shit dead.
Yep.
It's dead.
Exactly. So you have to really time them well.
Mm.
And really slap his.
That paw hand, exactly. You slap that paw hand.
Everyone's tried it.
Everybody. And here's the thing: we're sitting here trying to fucking beat a dead horse.
You just gotta do this.
No, man, here's what you gotta do. But the thing is that there's absolutely ways that, like, you can watch it like with an educated eye. You can see that there's holes in things. But the problem is this son of a bitch is just so good at what he does.
The other problem with Jon Jones is you can work him out.
Yeah.
But the moment you work him out, he just switches. Yeah.
He takes
you down. He spins. He fucking does something.
Y'all remember when he was just hitting dudes with takedowns and foot sweeps for days forever? Because yeah. he didn't have confidence in his striking against Lyoto and some of these other guys. So all of a sudden he's a fucking he's a Dan Kelly foot sweep dude all of a sudden.
100%. I'm trying to think who gave
I'll tell you who gave him his best run.
Stavison?
No, that first fight. But I'm saying a healthy John when he's not all fucking banged out beforehand. Fucking Vitor Belfort.